Hi, my name's Tiffany White. Me and my husband, we went to our first doTERRA class in October 2015. I went there just to kind of see what these essential oils are all about and actually why. So I heard that you can actually ingest these, and I had always learned that you never put essential oils in your mouth. So I wanted to go there and I was just curious to see what they were all about. We ended up leaving the class, and I was kind of nervous to ask my husband what he thought about it, and he told me that he was really interested in trying oregano. I was like, why oregano? I totally missed that part, but that was the one thing that when she was talking about the oils, that popped out to him. So he has had a plantar's wart on the bottom of his foot for several years, and another wart on the tip of his finger, and so he wanted to try it out. And he said that I was more interested because it was coming up to winter season, and I was interested in immune boosting stuff since we have a little girl and tend to get sick a lot around that time. So he said that we could look to see what we should try out, but he wanted to try oregano, and if that worked, then we could continue buying them. And we're here about a little over a year and a half later, almost 2 years later now since that class, and we are still buying it and doing something that I never thought that I would ever do, sharing these with everybody because we've just seen so many amazing benefits of having them in our house. Just been replacing lots of different things, and it's been great. I've been meeting lots of new people, and I just absolutely love it. So, today I'm going to explain what oils are, how to use them, and how to get them. So, if you like them, get them, and if not, it's not a big deal. So, essential oils, they give us a choice. Let's turn to page 4. So, what are essential oils? They're not something new. They are an ancient medicine that's being rediscovered. They're produced naturally by plants. So, they protect the plants from bugs, fungus, they slow the decay of the plants, and they just help out with the overall health of the plant. Many plants produce essential oils, not all of them, but the ones that do, they have their own medical benefits to them. And then, when properly removed, we can use them to support the functions of the human body. The way that we remove these plants or remove the essential oils from the plants is by two different ways. One is steam distilled, which is by the majority of them, and then there's also cold pressed, which is for the citrus fruits. They are chemically complex plant medicine. And they do have a wonderful aromas, and they have a very clean feel, and they're very quickly absorbed into the skin. They're very lightweight. So over on the next page, you'll see up there it says CPTG or Certified Pure Therapeutic Grade. So what that means, that is a trademark or certification, I guess, that doTERRA actually had to come up by themselves. Because there is no governing body for essential oils, so that means that there are no set standards. The only way to know if an oil is pure is to test it, and most of us don't have that equipment at home to be able to test ourselves, so you have to trust the company that you are buying it from, and I trust doTERRA. They have come up with a CPTG standard and are working with other members of the industry to bring up the standards. So they're trying to just kind of set a good example in hopes that other people are going to follow in after them. So in the meantime, you could be rest assured that doTERRA essential oils are 100% pure, making them safe and effective. So CPTG, that means that there's no fillers, no pesticides, chemicals, or artificial ingredients in there. They also go to where the plant naturally grows. So, where they naturally grow, the plants produce more potent oils, and so there's no need for pesticides. the plants are used to an environment. They're used to the bugs. They're used to all of that. So they don't need to spray them with chemicals. So we're kind of beyond organic. You won't see an organic label on any of the bottles because they're beyond it. They're not even using organic chemicals. So no, doTERRA does not have their own farms. Technically, we do, but we don't. We do not go around and get all these seeds together and then grow them right here in the U.S. because they probably wouldn't. I mean, I don't know how many of you have seen a frankincense tree around here. I personally haven't, because they don't grow naturally here. So they wouldn't grow potent. They would need to have chemicals sprayed on them to protect them from the bugs that they're not used to. So we go to the source. And then another way for us to have that CPTG standard is that every batch is rigorously tested by a third party for seven different things. And theirs is tested before and after the bottle, just in case there's something inside that bottle that is contaminating it. They want to find that before they send it to you. So doTERRA does believe in supporting its people with co-impact sourcing. So they partner with farmers in areas that are oftentimes impoverished, not all the time, but most they try to go to those communities, and they form cooperatives, which brings more jobs and a higher income. This empowers the growers, families, and communities all around the world. And then for us, it establishes a pricing with a trustworthy and higher quality supplier. There is no middleman, so we could have our prices lower and pay them more, which is really nice. So over on page six, the next page, you'll see down at the bottom, it says application methods. These are the three different ways that you can use essential oils, and each way has its own benefits. So you'll see each kind of looking around in this catalog, there's gonna be an A, a T, or an I next to it, and then an N, S, or D. So A means that it can be used aromatically. All of them can be used aromatically. T can be used topically. I can be used internally. Now, for internally, can't stress enough that I would not trust any other company to use the essential oils internally. I trust doTERRA because of all the testing that they do to ensure that you are getting 100% pure essential oil, what is marked on the bottle. Now for skin sensitivity, N is usually you don't need dilution, so it means neat. S is for sensitive skin, you might want to dilute it. And then D is you always want to dilute it because it's a hot oil. Like for instance, oregano is a really very, very, very hot oil. And same with cinnamon. And then I think thyme is another one. But you just want to make sure on there to see if it has a D on there, and just make sure you dilute it. So over on page 32, flip over there. 32, you'll see the diffusers. So going over the first way that you can use essential oils is aromatically. So diffusing it is amazing because the whole family gets to reap the benefits of it at the same time. So it's very cost effective. For instance, the paddle diffuser is the one that we use the most in our home. I use maybe five drops, maybe seven if I really want to smell it. And that could last up to 8 hours. There's a 1, 2, and 4 hour setting, but then you could set it for another 4 hours, and because there would be enough water in the tank to keep it going for 8 hours if you reset it. So that's a long time for five drops of oil for, you know, however many people are in your house at the time. So diffusing it, or just smelling it from the bottle or from your hand, it uplifts your mood. Helps out with your airways and your lungs, and also helps to purify the air. So I'm going to do a peppermint little, I don't know what you want to call it, experiment, I guess. So just 1 second. All right. So if you have peppermint, if you know anybody who has any breathing difficulties, like asthma or anything with breathing. This is excellent. It's great for seasonal threats, everything. So you just take your bottle of peppermint, your hand. This is your personal inhaler. So, and then just do one drop. If there's two, that's totally fine. And then rub your hands together. Now just avoid your eyes because you'll start crying. Well, you'll tear up, not necessarily cry. So when first thing that you do is cup your hand over your nose and your mouth. You just breathe in that way. It's really nice. And then your personal inhaler, you lay one hand flat, the other hand cone shape around the top, and then you just breathe in as deep as you can, just like you would an inhaler. So, and just hold it, and then you can do it as many times as you want. You won't get jitters. It just opens you up, and it tastes great. I think that's like the best part, honestly. It's really good. So peppermint and frankincense are really great to combine together for your to open up airways. And if you want to do a nice little pick-me-up, you could do peppermint and wild orange. That's the wake-me-up blend. So that one's really nice too. So if you look over on the page right next to it on page 33, they show you different ways to use it topically. So you could topically, you apply it to head, your feet, your ears, chest, back of neck, and other trouble areas, like directly to it. The safest way is bottom of your feet. So this right here gets through your bloodstream in about 30 seconds and hits every cell in your body in about 20 minutes. So it's very efficient and it's very safe because it's on the very bottom of your feet. The skin there is tougher, so irritation usually doesn't occur. I have actually put oregano straight right on the bottom of my daughter's feet and she's totally fine. Now, I don't suggest that you do that. Everybody can do that with their children or even with yourself. Definitely test it. But I have been able to do it with her and with myself too. So doing it topic using the oils topically, use your common sense. So please don't put it in your eyes, in your nose, or in your ears, in your ear canal. You can put it on the outside of your ear. Like a great way, you can put a drop of oil on a cotton ball and just kind of set it right on the outside of your ear canal. But don't drop it directly inside. If you do get an oil on you that seems to be hot or you're just a little bit more sensitive to it, use fractionated coconut oil. And you'll see that right up there. It's right next to the lotion on that page. You don't want to remove an oil with water because it'll actually push it in further and it'll enhance those effects, the any stain or irritation that you might be feeling. So just avoid water. And use an oily oil, like carrier oil. Like you can even use olive oil if you need to. Any cooking oil is a great one to just remove it real quick. Use a carrier if necessary. It's just as effective in ways. It's got a little bit more effective using a carrier with your essential oils because it slows the absorption and the evaporation weight or rate. Excuse me. So the essential oils, they evaporate really quickly. They're very, very lightweight. So having that carrier oil with it will actually kind of weigh it down and keep it on your skin longer, and it will absorb into your skin slower. So you're actually getting the benefits of it over a longer period of time and not as quickly. So it allows your body to use more of the essential oil, and it so in a way it saves you more money in the long run. Using a carrier oil or lotion, it encourages massage, which brings blood to the surface, allowing more oil to seep deeper into the tissue, which is really nice. So this lotion that you see on there, that's unscented. So you could add whatever oil that you want to, or you can use it just like that, just as is if you don't want to scent at all. So the third way is internally. So on page 53, flip over there. You'll see over there on page 53, there's four different soft gels. So there's the Digestin, On Guard, Trais, and Zendikrin. So they have a couple of the oils and blends already encapsulated for you to make it easier to take internally if you don't want to taste it, or if you just want to, you know, quicker things, so you don't want to, you know, drop, you know, wait for the drops or put it under your tongue. It's quick. Now, as you see, there's only four. If there was another oil that you wanted to take internally but you didn't want to taste it, they have little veggie caps, empty veggie caps, which I don't know where that page is right now, but they're empty little veggie caps, and you can actually fill them up with whatever essential oil that you want to. I do that all the time with lemongrass. After I have any kind of dairy, I will put like three or four drops in a capsule and take it, and I feel a lot better. So again, CBTG oils are safe to take internally. There are, I think, two of the oils that have a safety child cap on there, and you don't want to take those ones internally. That one's the deep blue and the wintergreen. There's other ones, if you look on the side of the bottle, they don't have a supplement fact. So for instance, I don't know if you can see this on the peppermint, there is a supplement fact right here. If you see that, then you know that there is a benefit of taking it internally. There's some of them that do not have the supplement fact on there. It's not necessarily going to be harmful for you, but there's no benefits. So you might as well not even try to take it internally. So taking it internally can help out with digestive issues, help out with anything in your mouth, your throat, or your liver. Taking it under the tongue is the fastest way to get it into your body. Just right under there's some veins in there, and it gets it in there really quickly. Veggie caps, easy way to do it. And then those pre-filled gel caps, and they also have some beadlets. That's in one of the beadlets is about a quarter of a drop. So it's just a nice way to, they have it for peppermint and the On Guard. It's just a nice way to have it. I love the peppermint one for a nice breath freshener. It's really nice. You'll use it in your water. Lemon is great in water. That's an excellent one to have every single day if you can. Have a nice easy cleanse at the end of the day. You could also use it in the food. I would use the oil, or put the oil in at the end of the cooking time, or on your plate itself, or in anything that's cold, so that because the heat can actually kill the properties in it. So it's really great to flavor it, but try to use it when it's not just in there just boiling. We kind of talked about topically earlier, but topically is kind of like taking it internally. So with that, with the CBTG oils, I would, in a way, for me, I would only trust having that quality of oil on my skin topically, since it's going into your body. So it's kind of like you're using it internally when you put it on your skin. So let's see here, sorry. So let's turn over onto page 9. All right, so here on page 9, you'll see the prices of all the single oils that doTERRA has. And then on page 27, we'll go there later, but those are where all the blends are. So here's where I would have somebody look to see what the most expensive oil is on here, and that would be Melissa. And it is, I believe, for wholesale, it's $115, or retail, $153.33. And then the least expensive would be lemon, which is lemon or lemongrass. Both of them, I think, are the same price. Yeah. So $10 and $13.33. So why do you think there is such a big difference in price on that? It would be because, for instance, with Melissa, producing only 1 pound of Melissa requires about 4 tons of plant material. And then the process of extracting that, of steam distilling it, is really strenuous. It's a long time. Melissa was actually out of stock for about 2 years until a couple months ago. It was back for 1 month. It sold out really quickly. So what happened, the reason why it was out was because there was a hailstorm that took out the whole crop. And so it just kind of left those farmers there going, what do we do? And doTERRA, they take care of their people, and they actually paid him for the rest of that year. I'm not sure if they paid him for the 2 years that it was gone, but I know that for sure that they did pay him for that year. So they didn't go without. So yeah, there, sorry, I kind of went off on a rabbit trail there. So Melissa, there's a lot, it takes a lot to make it. So that's why it's so expensive. And then lemon, on the other hand, is very plentiful, and they contain a lot more oil per lemon. So that's why it's only $10 for that. So over on page 19, we'll find the 10 most fundamental oils. And they come in most of the kits, the starter kits. And we'll talk about that a little bit later in a second. So over here on page 19, is a list of 10 of the most fundamental oils. They are considered the powerhouse oils. They take care of about 80% of your first aid and other health care needs, and they're very versatile. So just a second. All right, so the first oil that you see on there is frankincense. That's considered the king of all oils. So basically, if you don't know what oil to use, grab frankincense. It'll probably work. It's also great, really great for anything neurological. So I really like to put it on the back of my neck, or there's spots on your feet, like the big toe. That's really great for that too. Lavender is the next one on there. It's a very calming oil. I like to use that on any cut scrapes or burns. It's also really great for relaxing, so diffusing at night is really wonderful, or putting it on the bottom of your feet or on the back of your neck. Lemon, it helps. It's very cleansing and refreshing. Like I mentioned earlier, you put it in your water for a nice easy detox. It's also really great to remove sticky things. So I have a few videos actually that I made just kind of testing out the lemon oil to see what it can do. But it can remove the sticky residue of stickers, of price tags that they like to put on picture frames, the glass. It takes that right off. It takes sap off skin. It removes, I think it was like crayon or markers off of whiteboard, but it removes things really, really well. It's also good furniture polish. Peppermint kind of went over that a little bit. It is very cooling. It's excellent to be massaged up through your head, through your scalp, if you have any discomfort there, and great for helping to open up airways. There's lots of uses for it. It helps itching as well. Melaleuca is also, you probably heard it called tea tree oil. It's very good for skin, to clearing it up. Great for your nail beds. I like to, say hi to Josh. I like to use it with lavender. So first I'll put lavender over a cut or scrape, and then melt to soothe it. And then, gosh, and then Melaleuca over top of it. To help kind of kill any germs there. And then oregano's on there, great for immune support. So oregano, it's great for your immune system. It may make your house smell like an Italian kitchen when you diffuse it, but it's excellent for immune support. And also, like mentioned earlier, for planter's warts. It's excellent on getting rid of those, or helping getting rid of those. The next one on there is deep blue, and that is excellent for muscles and joints, and also bones support. So put it on there. It just helps. Just kind of, it soothes your muscles. Then breathe, just like what it says. It's the respiratory blend. You just put it over your lungs. You can even put it over your nasal passageways, or just breathe it in, just like we did the peppermint. And it just helps to break up any phlegm or anything in there, and just open up your airways. Digestion, you should put that right over your stomach. It helps out with any stomach discomfort or any type of gas. You also put that one underneath your tongue, or just drink it in water. They also have little soft gels. On that page, they have the soft gels, and also they have little tablets, kind of like the Tums tablets. And then the last one on the list there is En Garde, and this one's just great. I think it's one of doTERRA's favorite, but because they have a whole line of it, and I'll go to that page in a second. But En Garde, it just helps with your natural defense. It's great to diffuse. It's great to take internally. It just helps to boost up your immune support system. So we're on page 36. It shows all of the En Garde products. So 36, 37, and also on 38. They have lots of different things there. The En Garde Plus is excellent protective support. And the cleaner concentrate lasts forever. I have one of the got one of these at the beginning of the year, so that was about 7 months ago now. And I have gotten it, I think it's down to the top of the sticker, and I've used four or five, filled four or five 24-ounce spray bottles with just that little bit amount. So it lasts a long time and it works really great. It smells really, really good. Then they have a laundry detergent, hand wash, and our family's favorite is on page 38, which is the toothpaste. It's delicious. Our daughter can use it. There is no fluoride in it, but it helps to protect your mouth from anything. Then the En Garde throat drops are really, really tasty too, and they work excellent. So let's see here. Over on page 50 is one more thing I want to point out. So these are the daily vitamins that doTERRA has. So if you take a bottle of lemon, and I mean, just think about how much vitamin C you think would be in there. Most people would say 100% or 200%. There's actually zero. There is no vitamins in the essential oils. So what you're getting in the essential oils are the healing properties. They're like medicine, natural plant medicine. So doTERRA knows that there's, a need for that because there is because of poor farming practices, and the soil is just not very good quality. There is a need for a good vitamin in our daily diet. So the Lifelong Vitality is actually doTERRA's number one best-selling product. Sorry. So there is a multivitamin, omega with essential oils in there, and a cellular antioxidant and natural energy supplement. So if you don't have more energy and less pain, you can actually return it, even if it's empty, especially if it's empty, for a full refund after 30 days. So that's a 30-day money-back guarantee, which is really nice that they stand behind their products here. So a lot of people have a kind of a question: why are there essential oils in the vitamins? And there's a couple different reasons. One is it helps to act as a natural preservative, and the other one is it cuts down the oxidative. It helps cut down oxidation, which oxidation can results in aging. And also for the omegas, it helps the omegas in there, the fish oils, to not oxidate and to stay fresher longer, which is really nice. So you'll see there on page 51. It says buy one Lifelong Vitality or doTERRA Daily Nutrient Pack and choose up to three additional supplements at a reduced prices. So right next to that, you'll see this little purple box that says Loyalty Rewards Program. So there's a Loyalty Rewards Program. I'll explain in a second more on that. And you'll see that little purple box next to things all throughout here. And that means that you have an extra little incentive to when you're on Loyalty Rewards. So on Loyalty Rewards, you can get either one of these vitamin packs, either the Lifelong Vitality or the Daily Nutrient, and you can get up to three of these other supplements down here for a discounted price of $20. So just take a look at the multivitamin. It's the first one right there. So the Microplex MVP, you get it for $20 on this, or without the loyalty rewards, you'd be actually paying $39.50. So you're getting about half off being the loyalty rewards. So it's really nice, nice little benefit of having that. So how do you get the essential oils? On page 27, these are the oil blends. You'll see up there on the top, it says retail and wholesale prices. So doTERRA, they offer a wholesale account where you're able to purchase at wholesale cost with no monthly or minimum purchases required. So the wholesale cost is actually 25% off of the 25% less of retail. So once you're a wholesale, you have the option to participate in that loyalty rewards program if you wanted to. And in the loyalty rewards program, you earn credits towards free oils. Anyone can do it. It is the smartest way to buy. And each month you purchase, you get a percent back in credits. So you start out at 10% and go up each quarter until you get 30% back. So this, on top of that 25% that you're already saving, is like getting 55% discount. That's over half off of retail, being in loyalty rewards and a wholesale account. So most people, they do start with a kit because it offers the most savings. And I will show you that. All right, so most people start out with the kits. You don't have to start out with them, but it is the smartest way. You save the most money up front. So right here, you'll see right on the bottom here is the diamond kit. That is $2,500 and you get everything that doTERRA offers. So you're saving $804 getting the kit, and you'll get 400 product credits, which is basically like $400 they're giving you. And you get to start at 25% rewards instead of 10%. So they grandfather you in all the way at 25%. So that one, you get to save the most, you get everything. The next one up here is the Every Oil Kit. You save $285, you get 200 product credits, so like $200, and you get to start out at 20% instead of 10%. And this one, you get all of the oils and the cloud diffuser and the carrier. Then over on the other side, this right here is probably the most popular kit. It is the Natural Solutions Kit. I know everything's backwards on this, but this is the Natural Solutions Kit. You get to save $98, you get 100 product credits, $100, and you get to start out at 15% back instead of 10%. So this one, you try out several different oils, and then a little bit of each of the other products that they have. So it's just a really good sample of everything. The next most popular one is the Home Essentials Kit. You can save $86. You get those 10 essential, 10 most fundamental oils that I talked about here in the full size, plus you get a petal diffuser with it, which is really nice. Then there is the Family Physician Kit, and you get all of these oils, but you get them in, these ones are 15 milliliter, but these ones over here in the Family Physician Kit are only 5 milliliter, so it's a great way to just kind of sample them. And then without that one, you get to try out the beadlets, the peppermint and the On Guard beadlets. Then right up there above it is Emotional Aromatherapy Kit. So you get all the emotional oils. There's 6 of them. They're the newest blends that they came out with in October of 2015. Sorry, I forgot what year it was. So you get all those, plus you get the petal diffuser with that, and say $46. And then there's an athlete's kit. You get a few different oils there. You try out the deep blue rub, and then you try out the vitamins, then the deep blue polyphenol complex, which is helps out with inflammation in your body. Then there's the MitoChewMax, which is for natural energy without caffeine or any other stimulants in there. And then there is the Cleanse and Restore Kit. You just save $49 buying it that way. And it's basically to get your body detoxed and just kind of refreshened and ready to go. So it's a really nice kit there. So yeah, those are all the kits, and that's how to get into it. If you have any other questions, you would contact me at oilrevelation@gmail.com. And in the meantime, take care.